Every one of us is going to be questioned, all of us, about our time. What did we do with it? Allah gave you a chance. Yesterday was a chance. Today is a chance. Tomorrow is, inshallah, if you live, is a chance. What can you do? The past, you can't do anything. Everything that you've done in the past, all you can say is, Rabbi ghfirli. Oh Allah, forgive me for it. And the future that we keep thinking about is not in our hands. The thing that we have control over is the time that we're in. This is your time right now, brothers. Don't waste this time with people that don't have benefits in mind for you. They don't have good in heart for you. They would watch you destroy yourselves. No one will take sentence for you. If someone of you, one of you committed a crime on the streets, that friend that you are befriending will not help you. He won't say, I'll take the sentence in the years for you. How is he going to help you Yawm al-Qiyamah? When you stand in front of Allah Yawm al-Qiyamah. Are we all together, brothers? So now you have that chance. Now you benefit from it.
Another day in Ramadan, which means we usually start at 9 a.m. Before Ramadan, my days used to start at 4:30, but now, because of Ramadan and the breaking of your sleep and whatever, you have to wake up at like 3:30. So I usually get like maybe 3 hours and then 3 hours of sleep, but now, alhamdulillah, early morning starts 9 a.m. This morning, actually, I woke up at 8, so I was able to start earlier. So as you can see, they've got some nice little books here. I've already done a book review of all of the books to study in the previous vlogs. Do check that out, but make sure you try to read, of course, as much Quran as possible, but also do read some of the tafsir and also do read some Islamic books.
Oh, because the way you said it, it was just really funny. You were like, you know what's mad?
Absolute zero test. Maybe 2 days of recording.
I've got to it's not about honor. There's nothing wrong with it. Buy a tafsir to read and just go through a book like this, because I do it online, but I think the book's better.
Nothing beats books. You'd steal what he said that. He said,
you can't pray.
Yeah, fight or something. Exactly. Just got to finish the sentence.
Yeah, and so then I do it.
And then I think I will be inshallah, because one thing you lack is just. Yeah, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul.
Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. Basically, I make dua to Allah. Always make dua that Allah allows you to find the book and allows you to do the best ibadah for you from that night. Does that make sense? Everyone's ibadah is different. So I made this dua on the night that I thought it was, which was the 23rd. And that year everyone said it was the
23rd. Whoa, grab it. That's good.
Bro, you made my whole leg.
My bad.
You're not going to put it there anymore.
No. That was a quick save. Alhamdulillah. You know what they say, two heads are better than one.
It's actually too quiet.
Yeah, I know, it's bad quiet. Don't be scared. Guys, you know Zaid has actually like a, I don't want to say a phobia, but he's always like, oh, I don't want to do this, I don't want to do that.
What, social anxiety? Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salam.
It's weird.
Bro, why is no one chatting? Okay. It's because no one's chatting anymore over there. How can you? Oh, someone needs to chat.
Okay, you know what? Listen. Oh, what? This is not me. I'm not scared.
It's not about me scared.
In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, Rabbi Shahli, Sadri wa Sili, Amri wa Hadi Rukta, Min Lisan Yaqahu Qawli. So, today we're going to be talking about the last 10 nights of Ramadan.
Naam.
At the time of the recording of this video, it's nowhere close to the last 10 nights, but the last 10 nights, we're going to be very busy. The last thing we want to do is bring our camera and do the vlog. So, for now, we're going to talk about how you can utilize the last 10 nights of Ramadan. So, first of all, the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he actually said, تَحَرَّوا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ فِي الْوِتْرِ مِنَ الْعَشْرِ الْأَوَاخِرِ مِنْ رَمَضَانِ. Then look at Laylatul Qadr, try to find it in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, in the odd nights, so 21st, 23rd, 25th, 27th, and 29th. So now you know exactly roughly which nights to do more ibadah.
But however, you should make the most of every single night of the last 10 nights, because you actually don't know which of the nights it's going to be on.
Exactly. And Rasulullah the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, actually the hadith tells us, إِذَا دَخُلَ الْعَشَرْ شَدَّ مِئْزَرَهُ وَأَحْيَ لَيْلَهُ وَأَيْقَضَ أَهْلَهُ. That when the last 10 nights of Ramadan came in the last 10 days, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he actually used to شَدَّ مِئْزَرَهُ, he used to tighten his waist belt.
What does that mean?
What that means is that he would refrain from...
It's a metaphor for saying that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would increase in his ibadah. He'd really put it into gear 5 now, like, that's it, the going is getting tough, the tough is getting going, how's that work? He'd really strive in his ibadah and he'd really push himself. And it's also a metaphor for he would leave off worldly matters that were even halal for him, such as
being with his wife
and so on and so forth. Doesn't mean you have to do that, but this is just what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did.
Yeah, and he also used to keep his family away. And of course, Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum naru. O you who have believed, save yourselves and your families from what? From the hellfire. So, for example, if you are trying to do as many ibadah as possible in the last nights of Ramadan, and let's say you're married or you have children, or as a family member, or even if you're living with your friends, you should encourage them to also wake up and do as much ibadah as possible. And it's only 10 nights. And also the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said,
مَنْ دَلَّ عَلَىٰ خَيْرٍ فَلَهُ مِثْلُ أَجْرِ فَعْلِهِ.
Now, whoever guides someone to do something good, they also get
the reward of that good coming back to them in this life and in the next life.
It's not a share, by the way. It's a copy of the good deeds. Allah Azza wa Jalla is not going to just share. Don't think this is going to take away from your good deeds. No, rather Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to multiply it even more. So, yes. So, this is why it's very important that you use this last 10 nights very well.
And look, if you're someone who maybe has slacked off in the first 20 days of Ramadan, then these last 10 nights are the ones to really, really strive and struggle and push yourself. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in hadith, وَإِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالْخَوَاتِيمِ, that the actions are judged by their endings, i.e. you will be judged at the end of everything. At the end of your life, that's when it really matters. You know, how are you as a Muslim? The end of Ramadan. This is where you really show Allah that you truly love Him and you really put in that effort. So if you feel like you slacked off in those first 20 days, make sure in these last 10 days to make the most of them. And my Shaykh gave me some very beautiful advice. He said, make the most of these last 10 nights as if they were the last 10 nights of your life. How would you spend them? If these were the last 10 nights of your life, how would you spend them?
The last thing you would think about is money and this and that and worldly benefits. You'd just be focusing completely on worshipping Allah Azza wa Jalla.
And many people, they actually take time off specifically just to save these last 10 nights of Ramadan to be able to stay up the whole night so they don't have to go into work the next day. So if you're someone who is able to do that, then that's something good that you can do, inshallah.
And Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to multiply your reward. If you have the right intention, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّةِ. If you have the right intention that I'm going to take off work and Allah Azza wa Jalla so that I can spend that time to be with my family, help them and do as many good deeds as possible this last 10 nights of Ramadan, pray Qiyamul Layl as much as possible, pray Taraweeh, pray Tahajjud, and in case of Allah, that Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to give you so much more.
And pause.
Why are you so quiet, bro? Speak a bit loud. It's louder, brother.
Yeah, I know, I'm just...
وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Come on, brother.
There's a very beautiful story by mentioned by Imam al-Dhahabi, I think in Sirat Alam al-Nubala, by a man known as Abi Muslim al-Khawlani. Listen to this amazing advice. When the last nights of Ramadan came, you know what I mean? Or in general, he would stand up for the night prayer, the Qiyam al-Layl, the Tahajjud, the Taraweeh, so much, right? To the point that even if his legs got tired, because this happens to all of us, he would have a stick hanging there and he would grab his stick and he would hit his legs and he would say to his legs, أَنْتُمَا أَحَقُّ بِالضَّرْبِ مِنْ دَابَّتِي. You are more befitting that I smack than my mule or my horse that I ride on. How can I smack that to tell it to go faster? And you guys are getting tired. Of course I'm going to smack you. So you stay standing there worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for longer. Of course, these are just stories to motivate us. True stories, inshallah, to motivate us. When you feel like you're tired, remember this story. There may be a lot of sisters asking, how can I make the most of these last nights of Ramadan when I'm on my menstrual cycle? Because a lot of sisters actually go through that. What would you say?
Inna Allah la yudi'u ajr wal muhsinin. Allah Azza wa Jalla is not going to let your good deeds go to waste. Of course, there are limiting things that you can do. You're not able to pray and whatnot, and you're not able to fast. But you can still make dua to Allah Azza wa Jalla, and you can, of course,
make a lot of dhikr.
A lot of dhikr.
You can still give it in sadaqah, you can give in charity, you can still help out your family. Remember, it's all about intention. Indeed, an-niyyatu tijaratul ulama, that the intention is the trade and the business of the scholars, because they know that they can put their intention with anything and it will become an act of worship. So sister who is on their menstrual cycle, you can do so much. Don't waste these nights just thinking, oh, I can't pray. Still do everything else that you can do, inshallah. And remember the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in a very, very beautiful hadith, إِذَا مَرِضَ الْعَبْدُ أَوْ سَافَرَ كُتِبَ لَهُ مِنَ الْعَمَلِ مَا كَانَ يَعْمَلُهُ وَهُوَ صَحِيحٌ مُقِيمٌ. That if a slave of Allah is ill or they're traveling, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward that person, for the good deeds that they used to do when they were not ill or they were not traveling, i.e. in a normal state. So don't worry, just because you're on your menstrual cycle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows your intentions. وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in your heart, and He will reward you for the intention that you had, that you would have done these acts of worship in the last 10 nights. I hope this is some consolation. Is that the word, consolation, right? For the sisters, inshallah, do not despair, do not give up hope. Allah will reward you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah will never let the reward of those who do good go to waste. Don't forget that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ghafoorun Raheem. He's the most merciful. You think He's going to abandon you? Just because you're on your menstrual cycle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you with. So don't have bad thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and know that He is the best of planners. What else can people do in these last 10 nights?
Also, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ يَقُمْ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. Now whoever prays Laylatul Qadr with the hope that Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to forgive them, then غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to forgive you for all of your sins. And of course, we know the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَنْ قَامَ مَعَ الْإِمَامِ يعني في رمضان حتى ينصرف كتب له قيام ليلة. Whoever prays until the Imam leaves, so from the beginning when the Imam comes in and they pray, let's say Aisha, and then they pray whether it's 8 rak'ah or 20 rak'ah, and then they pray the witr, whoever leaves with the Imam, they will have the ajr of praying the whole night. And imagine Laylatul Qadr, you're praying the whole night just by praying the 20 rak'ah with the Imam, and then you get to go home and you get to do charity and you get to also do as much khair as possible. Imagine the amount of good deeds you'll get for that.
What else was I going to say? Some more useful tips that you can implement, inshallah, is to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow you to benefit and to make the most of these last 10 nights as if they were the last 10 nights on earth that you lived. Another amazing thing that you can do is to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He allows you to find Laylatul Qadr and to allow you to do the best kind of ibadah, worship that is specific for you on this night. I will
because
tell you
not every single person
exactly
is going through the same struggles.
Exactly.
And in fact, sometimes some good deeds might be specifically better for you to do than a specific other deed.
I'll tell you guys all a very amazing thing that happened to a brother. He told me this, that he made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he finds Laylatul Qadr. This was a couple of years ago. And that he told me that he made dua that he makes the best kind of ibadah, act of worship in this night. Anyway, that year particularly, he asked everyone and they all said that they thought it was the night of the 23rd. He was very upset, he told me. Why? Because on the night of the 23rd, he did no ibadah. He didn't pray any kind of taraweeh. He didn't give any charity. He did no dhikr, literally almost no dhikr, or you know, not as much as he normally would. He didn't even make dua. He basically did nothing of what you would expect. He didn't read any Quran in that night, on the night that everyone unanimously said this was Laylatul Qadr.
They believed.
Of course, no one knows. There's one thing that this brother did do though, and this is what he told me. He said that night particularly, out of the whole night, all of the 10 nights, was the only night my mum had come back from her travels, so we took her out to eat. And then when we got home, and this is took her out to eat for iftar, by the way. So you can imagine, they're out for iftar, there's no time for taraweeh. Come back home, and his dad was speaking to him for 2 hours about his job or just life. 2 hours. And the brother who was sat there was just thinking, I need to go do some ibadah. I need to go worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he stayed listening to his father, smiling and pretending that he was interested, all these kinds of things, for 2 hours into the night. And then when his father had finished speaking, he knocked out on the couch and he woke up at Fajr time.
Even though he was really angry and upset at what was going on between them and their father. So
exactly. So then this brother was told, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has inshallah answered your dua. He answered your dua. Why? Because Allah knows you're gonna give in sadaqah. Allah knows you are gonna read Quran. Allah knows that you are gonna pray the tarawih prayer. Allah knows that you are gonna do a lot of dhikr. But the best deed for you, perhaps, for you to get the most good deeds, was for you to have birr of your parents, was for you to be kind and treat your parents nicely. So perhaps Allah actually honored you and favored you and blessed you, such that the most difficult thing that you struggle with, which is to be good to your parents, you excelled in it and you did it very well on Laylatul Qadr, subhanAllah. So always make dua that Allah allows you to do the best kind of ibadah for you in this night.
And that is just one story out of many other stories. So as I said, every single person, the good deed that they do is very specific to them. Mm. But of course, try to pray as much as possible. Give sadaqah. Try to give so much. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Dhullu al-mu'min yawm al-qiyamati sadaqah."
Mm-hmm.
That the shade for the on Yawm al-Qiyamah for the believer is what is sadaqah. Sadaqah is going to be a shade. And so it's really going to help you. And especially nowadays with our Muslim brothers and sisters in Palestine that are being tortured and all the things that's happening. Donate as much as possible to reliable sources. And there will be
there's
some
one in my link
there
below.
In the description below.
There's one from my fundraiser. It's down below. It's 100%. 100% donation policy for the people of Yemen, Syria, Turkey. The masakeen, poor people who don't have much to eat and so on and so forth. It's an 100% donation policy. But also, if you want to donate to Palestine, also a 100% donation policy. The link is down below as well. But make sure to give something, inshallah. The other thing that I wanted to mention is that, subhanAllah, some of the Salaf, what they would do is, especially Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, it is narrated that he would take a ghusl, bath every night of the last 10 nights. I mean, this was his habit anyway. But he would take a shower on, you know, when it was the last 10 nights, like the night time came in, he would go and do a ghusl. Why? Because he knew Jibreel alayhi salam was coming down to the earth. So he wanted to, what? He wanted to be present in the presence of Jibreel alayhi salam in the most purified and beautiful state. Jibreel alayhi salam is the most noble angel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions. He is the angel that is the most, he's the angel that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw, and Allah says in Surah An-Najm, لَقَدْ رَأَى مِنْ آيَاتِ رَبِّهِ الْكُبْرَى. Rasulullah, he saw one of the greatest signs of the power and the majesty of Allah, and this is Jibreel alayhi salam in his full form.
Jibreel alayhi salam is an enemy of Allah.
And Jibreel comes down on Laylatul Qadr on this night of power. So this, what did they do? They would take a ghusl and perfume themselves and wear their best clothes because they would be in his presence. Subhanallah. So this is something that's very nice and touching that we can also try and do.
Also, one final thing I wanted to say about this night. And of course, we know Allah Azawajal said that إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ, that the Quran was sent down in what? Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَرْفَ, that the Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months, which if you do the little calculation on Google, is like 83.3 years roughly. And what's very important is please try not to argue with parents, with family, with siblings, with friends, and please don't do too much lagu, which is why, as I said, we're recording this video now because it's last 10 nights, last 10 days, you don't have time to vlog, you don't have time to go out every day with your friends after tarawih, get a milkshake, like I do sometimes, but you don't have that time.
You never shouted me, bro, not invited me.
I did invite Zaid to come to the milkshake little party, but he was still busy, he had to go, so next time inshallah. But it's very important that you use this night very, very wisely. Please try not to be angry at your Muslim brothers, and please forgive anyone that's done you any wrong. Just forgive them and ask people for forgiveness as well. So it's very important that you don't have any of this
animosity in your heart.
لا تباغضوا ولا تحسدوا ولا تدابروا وكونوا عباد الله إخوانا. Forgive your Muslim brothers and Allah Azza wa Jalla will forgive you inshallah.
And no shaitan will try and test you. Or no, Allah, shaitan will try and trick you, sorry, into causing a problem with your fellow Muslim brother or sister, or even your own parents. Do not fall for it. If someone annoys you, just remain silent and say inni sa'im, and just say I am fasting. Do not respond. Just learn the beauty of silence, especially in these last 10 nights. Do not ruin your Ramadan. Honestly.
Indeed, Satan is a clear enemy to you, so make sure you take him as an enemy. Anything that happens on that day, on those last 10 nights, and this is throughout the year anyway, but those last 10 nights, just say to yourself, no, this bad thoughts, I don't want to have it. It's time to actually focus. So make sure your head is fully geared in for those last 10 nights.
And this is the tabi'een would say, إنما هي أيام قلائل والموعد الجنة. Indeed, it is but a number of days. Mm-hmm. And the final destination is Jannah. So push yourself. Push yourself. This is advice to myself first and foremost, inshallah. Push yourself and you can take it easy when it's dead. You want to sleep, you will sleep in the grave, inshallah, for a long time. But in this dunya, while you still have time, make the most of it. Make the most of every single second, because you're going to see the reward for this on the Day of Judgment. You're going to see the reward for this in your grave. And inshallah, you will get a higher level of Jannah. So really, really always remember the final goal, which is Jannah, Al-Firdaus, close to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala.
في مقعد صديق عند مليك مقتدر. And they say Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah actually recited the Quran 80 plus times, 80 to 83 taqreeb, and that's what they say before he died in his jail, and this is the last few verses he was reciting. Anything which you've said that is wrong or incorrect is from us and the shaitan, and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Do you want to say that again, Zaid?
No.
Okay. We'll keep it between us then.
Is that bingo cat?
Yo, guys. I feel like, bro, look. He wants to fight.
Well, he doesn't
want to
fight, bro.
Oh. Yes, he does, man. He
looks like a puma.
Bro, don't let him bite you. Don't let him bite you.
It's okay, don't bite you, bro. It's okay,
I'm not
bro.
Going next to it, bro.
Come on, Torab. Bro, face your fist then, bro.
No,
face
bro. I'm not a cat guy.
I think he wants to go inside. I think that's the house.
I think that is the house.